about how we can find out and how much we can find out and what it takes to get there. So first we have to decide how much do we want to find out. So let's say in this case, I want to find out at a level of 7. Okay, so I find that level on my graph and I come horizontally to my gradient line. Where it intersects with my gradient line, I'm going to come straight down to where it intersects with my fuck around line. That there is going to tell me how much I have to fuck around to find out what I need to find out. See, as you can see, the more you fuck around, the more you're going to find out.
Okay, y'all. So I actually just finished interviewing potential faculty members for this program, which is crazy because I'm like, I'll be here for a couple months and they already trust my opinion. But anyway, I had the opportunity to, hold on, my camera looks a little, can't tell if that's better or not. Yeah, so I had the opportunity to interview these people applying to be professors at this university. And I was excited to do it because I'm like, this gives me the opportunity to kind of see both sides of it. So what does this look like being someone who would apply to a role in academia? What kinds of questions are being asked? You know, just all kinds of stuff, because everything has its own culture. And so I wanted to see like, okay, so, you know, what kinds of experiences are these people presenting with? So some people already hold faculty positions, other people are doctoral candidates and they're just about to graduate and so they're applying for these roles. And on the reverse end of that, how are the people at my university, the professors that are already there, the department, how are they discussing the candidates? What experiences are they looking for? Are people who are already in faculty positions, are they weighted differently than people who would be applying straight out of grad school? You know, like, is there like leverage there and already having the positions? How is teaching experience weighted? You know, just all of those different things. I got to be a part of the debrief after the fact. Where they were picking like the candidates for the second round of interviews, which was also very, you know, exciting and interesting. So I got to ask some of the questions and answer some of the questions that the interviewees had. But to get to listen to, you know, my mentors, my advisors, my professors, and what they took away from what was being said. At the end of that, I asked about certain mannerisms, nonverbal cues, because obviously everyone who interviews is going to be someone who is qualified. So what makes the people that you choose stand apart? What are some things that you're looking for? Insider tips, you know, just all kinds of things. What next steps would be? It was so interesting. I don't know. I still haven't decided, which I don't have to decide and I won't decide anytime soon, like definitively what it is that I want to do, but I'm keeping those areas open. And working to create the best foundation possible so that I'm on track where if I do decide to be someone who was interviewing for this position, I'm preparing now. And so that's giving me like a 5, 6, 7 year foundation of preparation before I would end up at this step. But all of that was just, it was just so interesting. I guess this is one of those professional development things, opportunities to not just take class, but to also get an insider scoop as to what being in the field would be like, what being a part of a department would be like, and yada yada yada. So I don't feel like, oh, there's no way I would do that. So that's relevant information from this experience. For my own reference, I think the way that I'm feeling right now is maybe a little bit excited because I can see myself in that role.
Shut up!
Professor. So that'll just be interesting to listen to years down the line to hear me say this now as a first year that like, I can see me doing this. So yeah, I'm gonna keep y'all updated about what this, everything that's going on. We're still in our first semester of the PhD, but we're making some like leeway. Like today I had to pick out the classes that I was going to be doing for next semester, which is crazy to think about because already it's time for me to start preparing for semester two. But so yeah, my entire approach to grad school is to just ride the wave, not making it longer than what it needs to be, but definitely not trying to rush it, just being with it.
Dude.
And in doing that, the time has been passing by really quickly. Yeah, all is well. All is well.